Welcome to Saju Matthew Online Safety University.
Hello sir, how are you?
I am fine, thank you.
Sir, actually, I have been noticing that there has been a lot of accidents around and unsafe vehicle operation are contributing a lot of accidents and you know many people they are losing their life.
Yes, yes.
So I just want to discuss something about vehicle operation today.
Yes, vehicle operation is one of the major operations happening at workplace. And if you take the overall statistics of workplace accidents and injuries and accidents, 37% of the workplace accidents or injuries are due to vehicle and equipment operation. So it's a responsibility of every employer to have ultimate care with respect to vehicle operation. Of course, this point need to be discussed, and even for higher level examinations also these questions are being asked, especially for RSP examination, registered safety professional examination, certificate safety professional examinations, in RSM examination, everywhere these questions are being asked. Vehicle operation is one of the major topics to be discussed actually. Very much.
Thank you, sir. So, I just want to know what are the main hazards associated with vehicle operations?
Yeah, what are the major hazards associated with the vehicle operation? The major hazards associated with the vehicle operation are, you can say simply, if you remember an acronym, that would be sufficient, LOC, loss of control, overturning and collision. Loss of control, overturning and collision. How, we know how the vehicle can go out of control or loss of control. Loss of control can occur due to overspeeding, overloading, lack of maintenance or poor maintenance of the work equipment, poor competence of the operator, loss of control can again occur due to lack of maintenance, then hit by other vehicle and equipment, operating in bad weather, like visibility is getting impaired, so it can go loss of control, then sudden health related issues arising because the operator while he is driving, he is developing with a heart attack, massive heart attack, it can also lead to loss of control. So loss of control can occur due to overspeeding, overloading, poor maintenance of the equipment, hit by other vehicle and equipment, operating the equipment in adverse weather conditions such as heavy rain, snow, fog, etc. Sudden development of health related issues to the operator, then hit by other vehicles. These are the common cause of loss of control. Then overturning. We know how the overturning can occur. Overturning can occur due to uneven weight distribution. One side weight up, one side low. So uneven weight distribution can lead to overturning. Then operating on unsuitable ground means uneven grounds that also can lead to overturning. Then riding on something, people are in the habit of driving on some items lying on the road. So driving on items on the road can also cause overturning of the equipment. Then lateral and longitudinal instability. You know what is lateral and longitudinal instability? Lateral instability in the sense, see when a vehicle is moving through a curve. So if the center of gravity is not matching, what will happen? It will topple down like this. So especially when taking a curve, lateral instability. Longitudinal instability in the sense, when a vehicle is going through a steep or a slope, if the load is more onto the front side, what will happen? The load will topple down like this. The vehicle will topple down. This is lateral and longitudinal instability. So overturning can occur due to overloading, driving on items on the road, then even uneven weight distribution, lateral and longitudinal instability, and unsafe practices. These are the common cause of overturning. Then third hazard associated with the vehicle operation is collision. Collision can occur due to overspeeding, poor visibility of the vehicle, sudden development of defects, like for example, suddenly the brake is missing. So it can also lead to collision. Tail driving in the sense where the driving so close to the vehicle, driving on others' blind spot. See, the front driver may not be able to see the person in the behind. If they are driving so closely to it, correct or not? So driving on others' blind spot, that can also lead to collision. Because now, when you are driving so close to the vehicle, if the front vehicle is all of a sudden applying brake, naturally the vehicle behind will go and hit. So that is why the tail driving is another reason for collision. Collision can occur due to unsafe practices such as tail driving, driving on the blind spot of others, sudden development of health related issues to the operator, both operator, then poor visibility, sudden brake failure or mechanical failure can lead to collision of vehicles. These are the common hazards. In addition to this, the LOC, loss of control, overturning and collision, in addition to this, poor competence of the operator, poor road condition, traffic road conditions, poor vehicle condition, stress of the individual. You see, especially for long distance drivers, when they are continuously driving, they will be under stress. Even stress can lead to collision of the vehicle. So, poor road condition, stress of the individual, health related issues, sudden development of health related issues, then vision trouble, because when people become aged, their vision goes down. So, vision troubles, driving under the influence of drugs and alcohol. That's one of the major problems these days. Driving under the influence of drugs and alcohol, not using the seat belts. That's also a hazard actually. Not using the seat belts, using mobile phones while driving, smoking while driving, then the load, load going here and there, unsecured load also can lead to toppling down of the equipment, unsecured load, and even fire, because of the poor housekeeping. Sometimes what happens, people don't maintain inside cleanness, they don't maintain, flammable material may be stored inside, that can even promote fire. So fire, these are the common hazards associated with the vehicle operation. If you remember all these points, I'm sure it is more than sufficient even for 10 more questions. Okay, so these are the common hazards associated with the vehicle operation. Do you want me to repeat? Once again,
yes.
The common hazards associated with vehicle operations are LOC, loss of control, overturning and collision. Loss of control can occur due to operating on uneven ground, lack of maintenance of the equipment. Loss of control can again occur due to driving under the influence of drugs and alcohol. Then, uneven weight distribution, sudden development of health related issues of the operator, poor visibility, poor condition of the vehicle, lack of maintenance, hit by other vehicle and equipment, then driving on others' blind spot, tail driving, uneven weight distribution, then lateral and longitudinal instability, operating on rough terrain, hit by other vehicles, poor visibility, adverse weather condition, then overloading of the vehicle, driving on any items lying on the road, overloading and driving on any other items lying on the road, then driving under the influence of drugs and alcohol, physical stress of the driver or operator, then production environment gives naturally what will happen, they will be in hurry. So naturally when they are in hurry, that lack of concentration will be there, so accident possibilities are more. So stress, mental stress, physical stress of the individual, inadequate brakes in between the shift, especially for long distance drivers. When they are driving continuously, if there is no adequate brakes between the shift, there is a possibility of sleeping during the driving. So that also can lead to, that's why physical stress also can cause harm during the driving. So these are the common hazards associated with the vehicle operation. Is it clear?
Thank you so much, sir. It is very clear.
Okay, fine.
So I have one more question.
Please.
What are the factors to be considered while making risk assessment with respect to vehicle operation?
Yes, very good. In order to ensure safe vehicle operation, we need to carry out a suitable and sufficient risk assessment. Before assigning driving task, we must carry out a suitable and sufficient risk assessment. Now, what are the factors to be considered while carrying out a risk assessment with respect to vehicle operation? That's a question here. So it was last question even in the higher level diploma question examinations also. See, while carrying out a risk assessment with respect to vehicle operation, you have to consider what type of vehicle you are using, whether you are using a light vehicle or a heavy vehicle, what type of vehicle we are using, what is the duration of operation, are we going to use it from morning to evening, what is the duration of operation, what about the pedestrian movement during the time of your operation. Suppose, for example, in the factory opening hours, lot of pedestrians will be coming in, lot of light vehicle, two-wheelers, four-wheelers, and your luggage carrying vehicle also might be moving. So you have to consider the timing of the vehicle, type of vehicle being used, the nature of the operation you have to consider, pedestrian movement characteristics you have to consider, condition of the traffic routes you have to consider, whether the traffic routes, do you have a one-way system or two-way system, whether the traffic routes are well maintained or not, pedestrian routes are there or not, adequate separation between the pedestrian route and the traffic route is there or not, zebra lines for crossing zebra lines, it is there or not, the illumination level is adequate or not, what is the steepness, like a steep means how slope it is, what about the curve in a traffic route, Clear? How well maintained? It is well maintained. Where the edge protections are provided or not, as far as traffic route is concerned, adequate edge protection is provided or not. Whether in the T junctions, do you have convex mirror or not, otherwise there is a possibility of collision. So how the traffic route, the condition of the traffic route you have to consider. First of all, while considering a risk assessment with respect to vehicle operation, type of vehicle, number of vehicle being used, number, the characteristics of the pedestrian movement, other vehicle movements you have to consider. The timing of the vehicle operation you have to consider, whether it is a school opening hours, like a school hours, morning time children will be moving, the school buses will be moving, so you have to consider the timing of the vehicle operation. And the duration of the vehicle operation also you have to consider. The distance to be covered, how far, how much distance the vehicle operator we have to cover, that also you have to consider. What are the communication facility available in the vehicle? Like for example, when you are going for long trips, there must be adequate communication arrangements to contact their parent office. So what type of communication arrangement they have in a vehicle, that also they have to consider. Condition of the vehicle, whether the tire pressure is adequate, whether the fuel is sufficient, whether the oil is updated, whether the water level is okay or not, rear view mirror is working, then the wipers are working well, and the horn is working well, all the lights are working well or not. So condition of the vehicle we have to check. Clear? Then the load, what type of load you are carrying, that also very important, because sometimes what happens, flammable and combustible materials when you are carrying, there are possibilities of fire. So what type of load you are carrying, that also you have to consider. And considering the risk assessment with respect to vehicle operation, you have to consider the competence level of the operator. Whether he is competent enough to drive this vehicle. Then his experience. Whether he is physically fit, whether he is having any vision trouble or something like that. What is his health condition? That also you have to consider. So while assigning a vehicle operation, a suitable and sufficient risk assessment need to be carried out. Is it clear?
Yes sir, very clear. Thank you sir.
Welcome.